Joining me now via Skype from Ventura, California, is Sharon McNary of KPCC Southern California Public Radio. Sharon, you've been out reporting already this morning. What have you seen?
Well, the most moving thing I've seen is the people who are telling me about the loss of their homes. And these are people from every income level. I mean, people who had luxurious cabins up in the woods to people who had, you know, very modest homes down in the flats. And what's more, it's still unclear from the authorities exactly how many dwellings have burned. The number of structures destroyed is 537, but some of those structures are very big apartment buildings. So the loss of homes could be far larger.
And the weather seems nice where you're standing, but have the winds cooled down? Are the firefighters getting a better chance today to fight some of these?
Yeah, today's winds are pretty calm. They're expecting it to kick up to about 10 to 20 miles an hour later today. But it's nothing like the 40 to 60 mile an hour gusts that we were seeing a couple days ago. So what they're saying is that this fire has transitioned from a wind-driven fire to a topography-driven fire. So the terrain is what's going to determine where the fire goes.
And there are so many different fires to worry about. Are there areas that they're concerned where the fires are kind of slowly heading toward?
In this fire, the Thomas Fire, which is occupying a big piece of Ventura County on the coast of California, the fire is heading north on the coast toward the Santa Barbara County line and a city called Carpinteria. Last I checked, it was about a mile from the county line. And then you kind of a big horseshoe shape that goes around Ojai. So many, many homes in Ojai were saved. But then north of Ojai and extending again to the west into a wilderness area, that fire is running along the south slope of some mountains. It's also heading north into the Sespe Wilderness area and a potential condor sanctuary, the condor being the state bird of California.
Have you talked to some of the people who've been kind of now looking through the rubble of what's left of their homes?
One woman I talked to, her husband had done an enormous amount of woodwork on this cabin that they lived in. And she thought they had a well-protected house with fireproof shingles and, you know, all the protections, good brush clearance. And, of course, the firestorm that came through Monday night was so strong, just a wall of flames, wind whipped. There was no chance of saving it. And so she's gone back, and it's heartbreaking.
What about the air quality that's affecting a much, much larger swath of the population in Los Angeles, even if they're not directly affected by the fires?
I hate to think of what I took into my lungs in the years when I smoked, but I'm feeling that same hit on the lungs. It's murky, it's dark, and with the wind not being as active, it's just sitting on the terrain, and it's just awful. And it's you know, you're in New York where people are talking about snow. It's snowing ash here. It's just miserable.
All right, Sharon McNary of KPCC Southern California Public Radio. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for your interest.